Hey friends, it's Mike, the Hi-Fi Insider. Today I want to give you guys my thoughts on the new Apple Vision Pro headset. Now, we've had a couple of days to sink in on the information that were provided by Apple and the people that attended the event, and I got to try it out. I have my thoughts about this product, and I'd like to share it with you. So the Vision Pro, I think the name is excellent. We initially thought that through the rumors, it would be called Reality Pro or Reality Headset. And I think I was hesitant to think that Apple would call it anything reality because, you know, the memes would say, well, you know, so anything else would be not reality, right? Not real. So that would be a stupid name for Apple to use. And I think Vision Pro, it's appropriate because it allows you to see the world very differently. And I think that's Apple's approach with this product. And I think Apple's long game with this product will be for it to replace a lot of their own products, you know, even the Mac or the iPhone. I mean, Apple is certainly not shy about making products that replace their most popular product, right? Because remember back in 2007, the iPod was the best-selling thing Apple has. And they simply replaced it with the iPhone. And the iPod became an app on the iPhone. You know, of course, it took a few years for this to happen, but eventually it did happen. And I think, you know, what we saw at the keynote was really just how Apple initially imagines this product to be and then allowed the developers or its customers to decide what they want it to be. For example, when the Apple Watch came out, Apple really threw everything at it to see what sticks, right? And now, you know, eight generations later, Apple Watch is really become the health and fitness product for a lot of people. And Apple is really leaning on that direction now. Why I think this product has a future, while a lot of people say it doesn't because they don't want to be in a metaverse. If you notice that Apple did not use the words VR or metaverse, they want this to be, you know, something that you can enjoy for entertainment purposes, or if it's something that you actually need for maybe accessibility. Apple is well known for making their accessibility features to be very good, especially on the phone, for anyone who is visually impaired or hearing impaired. Imagine the headset will allow people who are visually impaired to walk around the street without their stick, right? And to be safer, so it could alert them of an oncoming danger like a car or a bicyclist or, you know, other things like, you know, door, and which they have already demonstrated on the iPhone that they can identify what a door is and if the door is open or not. And they can, this headset will actually be much more useful for these people to be able to, you know, virtually see the world. Of course, the headset will go down in size as, you know, it matures. But I think this initial product is pretty well thought out. Another thing that I think there's a future for Apple with this product is Apple can actually make money by selling you content on this headset. So, for example, if you want to see a museum, right, a museum like the Louvre, and you don't have time or you don't have the money to travel to France, these museums can sell you a ticket virtually visit the museum, and it'll be of course significantly less than a real in-person visit. And Apple can basically be the ticket master of this type of recurring revenue, really, because they can sell all kinds of things, right? Concert tickets, sports tickets. You can just imagine all the things that you can physically go to, but can also be visited virtually with this Vision Pro. Of course, it's not going to be as good as the real thing, but something is better than nothing, right? If you can't afford to go to a, or if you can't buy these the Taylor Swift concerts, right? The tickets. I mean, what if Taylor sold you a lower price ticket that basically gives you the front row seat to her concert? And Apple can basically be the ticket master of this program, right? Also, you know, for people, for companies who are selling these virtual tickets, they can fit a lot more people at one show than a physical venue, right? You know, a lot of venues can only hold up to, you know, 10,000 or 20,000 tickets, people. So they can sell millions of tickets, right, for once, for the same show. And of course, Apple will always take a baby step approach to this. You know, they know that a lot of people are not ready for such a leap. So let's talk about the design of the headset. And I think Apple really nailed a lot of the concerns that I had going into this idea. Because, you know, being able to see your real world is very important. Nobody can actually walk around, even the house, without tripping on something if you can't see where you're going, right? So being able to render your space within the goggle by using those cameras was a very smart thing to do. And also, you know, being able for other people to see your eyes is also very, very smart. The entertainment prospect of this headset will be gigantic. I mean, just imagine if you want a large screen TV in your house, right? I mean, my TV room right now can only fit a 65-inch, but I want an 85-inch or larger, but I can't physically put that in there. But this headset will allow me to basically get a 100-inch or more screen, give me the perception of that size within the headset. You know, if you think about 100-inch TVs, it's going to cost more than $3,500. Plus, you need the space to put it, right? And with this, when you're done with this headset, you can just put it in the drawer and you never have to see it again. If you think about $3,500, it's actually quite inexpensive for the amount of things that you can do with it. And if you want to use it like a computer monitor, I mean, for me, my 6K Pro XDR monitor, right? I mean, that costs $6,000. So this is actually, you know, a little bit more than half of my monitor, my 32-inch monitor, but this can actually be bigger than 32 inches. Apple is very brave, for sure, for doing this because it is a very, very different thing that people cannot even imagine wearing right now. But just like the AirPods back in 2016 when, you know, they introduced AirPods, people laughed at it. People thought it was stupid looking. But a couple of years later, everyone wants AirPods because they were the coolest damn thing in the world. Well, let me know your thoughts on it, your feelings about this product in the comment section. And do you agree with my current outlook on this product? And what your thoughts on it, if you want to buy one or not? Do you think it's overpriced? Or do you also think, like I do, that it's underpriced? Thanks, everyone. I'll see everyone in my next video. Bye-bye.